Hi, and welcome to IP security. There are application-specific security mechanisms for a number of application areas, including for mail, SMIME, PGP, for client-server, Kerberos, web access, secure socket layer, and others. However, have security concerns that cut across protocol layers. For example, an enterprise can run a secure private IP network by disallowing links to untrusted sites, encrypting packets that leave the premises, and authenticating packets that enter the premises by implementing security at IP level. An organization can ensure secure networking not only for applications that have security mechanisms, but also for many security ignorant applications. IP level security encompasses three functional areas, that is, authentication, confidentiality, and key management. The authentication mechanism assures that a received packet was, in fact, transmitted by the party identified as the source in the packet header. In addition, this mechanism assures that the packet has not been altered in transit. The confidentiality facility enables communicating nodes to encrypt messages to prevent eavesdropping by third parties. The key management facility is concerned with the secure exchange of keys. In this chapter, we begin with an overview of IP security, that is IPsec, and an introduction to IPsec architecture. We then look at each of the three functional areas in detail. After going through this particular module, one should be able to explain the difference between transport mode and tunnel mode, understand the concept of security association, explain the difference between the security association database and the security policy database, summarize the traffic processing functions performed by IPsec for outbound packets and for inbound packets, present an overview of encapsulating security payload, discuss the alternatives for combining security associations, present an overview of internet key exchange, summarize the alternative cryptographic suites approved for use with IP security. These are the topics which will be covered in the upcoming lectures: IP security overview, IP security policy, encapsulating security payload, combining security associations, internet key exchange, cryptographic suites. IP security overview. Basically, it provides authentication, confidentiality, and key management. In 1994, the Internet Architecture Board, IAB, issued a report titled Security in the Internet Architecture, RFC 1636. The report stated the general consensus that the internet needs more and better security and identified key areas for security mechanisms. To provide security, the IAB included authentication and encryption as necessary security features in the next generation IP, which has been issued as IPv6. Fortunately, these security capabilities were designed to be usable both with the current IPv4 and the future IPv6. Applications of IP security. IPsec provides the capability to secure communications across a LAN, across private and public WANs, and across the internet. Examples of its use include secure branch office connectivity over the internet. A company can build a secure virtual private network over the internet or over the public WAN. This enables a business to rely heavily on the internet and reduce its need for private networks, saving cost and network management overhead. The second one, secure remote access over internet. An end user whose system is equipped with IP security protocols can make a local call to an internet service provider, ISP, and gain secure access to a company network. This reduces the cost of toll charges for traveling employees and telecommuters. Third one, establishing extranet and intranet connectivity with partners. IPsec can be used to secure communication with other organizations, ensuring authentication and confidentiality, and providing a key exchange mechanism. And finally, enhancing electronic commerce security. Even though some web electronic commerce applications have built-in security protocols, the use of IP security enhances that security. IPsec guarantees that all the traffic designated by the network administrator is both encrypted and authenticated, adding an additional layer of security to whatever is provided at the application layer. An IP security scenario. Figure illustrates a typical IP security scenario. An organization maintains LANs at desired locations. Non-secure IP traffic is conducted on each LAN for traffic off-site through some sort of private or public WAN. IPsec protocols are used. These protocols operate in networking devices such as a router or firewall that connect each LAN to outside world. The IPsec networking device will typically encrypt and compress all traffic going into the WAN and decrypt and decompress traffic coming from the WAN. These operations are transparent to workstations and servers on the LAN. Secure transmission is also possible with individual users who dial into the WAN. Such user workstations must implement the IPsec protocol to provide security. Benefits of IP security. Some of the benefits are, when IPsec is implemented in a firewall or a router, it provides strong security that can be applied to all traffic crossing the perimeter. Traffic within a company or work group does not incur the overhead of security-related processing. IPsec in a firewall is resistant to bypass if all the traffic from the outside must use IP and the firewall is the only means of entrance from the internet into the organization. IPsec is below the transport layer TCP/UDP and so is transparent to applications. There is no need to change software on a user or server system when IPsec is implemented in the firewall or router. Even if IPsec is implemented in the end systems, upper layer software, including applications, are not affected. IPsec can be transparent to end users. There is no need to train the users on security mechanisms, issuing key material on a per user base or revoke keying material when users leave the organization. IPsec can provide security for individual users if needed. This is useful for off-site workers and for setting up a secure virtual subnetwork within an organization for sensitive applications. IPsec routing applications. In addition to supporting end users and protecting premises systems and networks, IPsec can play a vital role in routing architecture required for internet working. HUIT 98 lists the following examples of the use of IPsec. IPsec can assure a router advertisement. A new router advertises its presence, comes from an authorized router. A neighbor advertisement. A router seeks to establish or maintain a neighbor relationship with a router in another routing domain, comes from an authorized router. A redirect message comes from the router to which the initial IP packet was sent. A routing update is not forged. Without such security measures, an opponent can disrupt communication or divert some traffic. Routing protocols such as Open Shortest Path First, OSPF, should be run on top of security associations between routers that are defined by IPsec. The IPsec documents. The IP specification has become quite complex. Key management. The totality of the IPsec specification is scattered across dozens of RFCs and draft IETF documents, making this the most complex and difficult to grasp of all IETF specifications. The best way to keep track of and get a handle on this body of work is to consult the latest version of the IPsec document roadmap. The documents can be categorized into the following groups. The first one, architecture, that covers the general concepts, security requirements, definitions, and mechanisms defining IPsec technology. See RFC 4301. Security Architecture for the Internet Protocol for more information. Authentication Header, AH, is an extension header for message encapsulation, now deprecated as shown in IP Authentication Header of RFC 4302. Encapsulating Security Payload, ESP, consists of an encapsulating header and a trailer used to provide encryption or combined encryption authentication, which can be seen in RFC 4303 IP Encapsulating Security Payload, ESP. The Internet Key Exchange, IKE, a collection of documents describing the key management scheme for the use of IP security, which can be seen in RFC 4306 Internet Key Exchange, IKE V2 protocol and other related RFCs. Cryptographic algorithms, a large set of documents that define and describe cryptographic algorithms for encryption, message authentication, pseudo random functions, and cryptographic key exchange. Others. There are a variety of other IPsec related RFCs, including those dealing with security policy and management information based MIB content.